Godbluff is de 5th studio album by the progressive rock band Vandegraaff Generator, requested by Rock Dude. I forgot to do Vandegraaff for a little bit because I was doing other things. But we are back again with another album review and today we're doing their 5th record. So we have 4 tracks on here, so I will keep it briefly on here. Yeah, they just released, you know, some of their most acclaimed records. I believe H to the E, At Least We Can Lose Wave to Each Other, I believe that was released as well. Palm Hearts, if it didn't set it already, so there we go. So they had some classic albums already. And they were just about to release another classic piece in their discography. Yeah, so there we go. We have the first one, which is The Undercover Man. This is a pretty slick and a pretty dark sounding prog rock song. It has a lot of nice sweets. It's not too long, you know, it doesn't drag on for too long. The song is the shortest of the record. It is 7 minutes and 32 seconds long, so that will... So this record is filled with epics, so there we go. Definitely a classic tune, I did really enjoy it. If there's something I would recommend to the record or maybe give a tip about it, then I would say it was a little bit too dark for me. It was a little bit too nasally, or not nasally per se, but just a little bit too, I don't know. Maybe have a little bit more catchiness to the record, but you know, that comes later. But definitely on this track it was the least, but it was still pretty notable though. It just needed some time to start up, so there we go. Then we have Scorched Earth, and this is a pretty epic track. I just really love the epicness of this record. It just, you know, it has some crazy time signatures. You know, everything, the instrumentation is really great. The title itself, Scorched Earth, it sounds awesome. Just everything about this song, it's just plain awesome. I can't really express my love for this song because it's incredible. It's a great closing piece for side one. I just really enjoy it. Everything about the song is great, so that's basically my word for it. Then we have Arrow. This is kind of the more technical song on the record. I believe it's like instrumental for like a little while. This song just amazed me, man. You know, it was just like song after song. It just went better and better. And Arrow is an incredible song. It has crazy time signatures once again. And overall, the song is just plain killer. I can't really express it again because it's so awesome. Arrow, you know, it just sounds awesome as well. It sounds, you know, interesting. What are you going to do with it, Arrow? The song, once again, just, you know, just comes at you with, you know, zero fucks. You know, it is just really relentless. What's happening on this track is really unexplainable. You really have to hear it for yourself because... you know, this record is just, yeah, speechless, really. It is really unexplainable what is happening on this track, so really check it out for yourself. It's an awesome track. And then we have The Sleepwalkers, which is the final song of the record. Really awesome song. It's the 10-minute epic of the record. Yeah, this song just kind of, you know, does everything that the record already had achieved up to that point. So there we go. Yeah, it is just overall a really epic tune. The Sleepwalkers, you know, what does the record mean with that? You have no idea, but I actually have no idea as well. But it is a pretty mellow track. I would say that this song acts perfectly as a closing song. You know, it is really mellow, really nice to listen to. Very nice track overall, so... I did love the song as well. It is just a great tune. So there we go. Do we want to say more about it? I don't really have anything more to say about it, really. Just, you know, the length is perfect. The Sleepwalkers, it sounds great, you know. Sleepwalking out of this record, ending it closely, you know, mellow and peaceful. That's how you close out a record, in my opinion. And they do that here, so yeah, I don't really have any gripes against the record, and overall it's a fantastic record, so there we go. I don't have anything more to say about it really, so I'm just gonna give my rating here. I'm gonna give this record a 9.2 out of 10, so there we go. Let me know what you thought about this record in the comments down below. Really the only grasp I have against it, that side 1 is just kind of weaker than side 2. But again, you know, the record is just getting better and better with each track after the other, so there we go. Yeah, let me know what you thought about this record by Vandegrift Generator, God Bluff. I'm gonna do more record by them. I believe all of their 70s work, except for the last one, is Requested Baroque. So if you want me to do their last 70s record and their remaining discography when they regrouped again in 2005, then I can do that for sure. Let me know in the comments if you are interested in that. I know Rockdo is, but maybe, you know, you guys, other guys maybe as well are interested in that. So let me know what you thought about it in the comments down below, and I will see you guys in the next video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, do all those things in the comments down below. Or do all those things in general, and let me know in the comments what you thought about this video. There we go. God bless, safe, take care, and peace.